Another day, another 1 liter TSI video. It just seems India doesn't get enough of 1 liter TSI content. But if you like it, we're going to keep on making it. And today we have the brand new Rapid 1 liter TSI automatic. The thing with the Rapid's looks are, you need to get the correct variant for it to look really good. Don't get me wrong, it's an amazing design. You have a sharp and aggressive front end with a pretty simple back end with clean and hard lines going down the side. The deal breaker for me is the wheels.
I mean, come on. The 15-inch rims that Skoda provides in the lower variants are really, really hideous and totally ruins the design of the car.
The ones to have are these, the clubber 16-inch rims. This is the style variant, so the look is pretty basic with a silver color on top. But if you get the Monte Carlo, you actually get a diamond cut effect on top. But they've introduced brand new wheels called the Stratos rims, and they're basically superb rims for your Rapid.
The boot space of the Rapid is 460 liters. Not the biggest you can get, but more than enough. The opening of the boot is spot on and you can fit big bags very easily.
Now, many people have been complaining that the Vento, Polo and Rapid have gone outdated and their interiors just aren't as good as the ones in the newer cars from Hyundai and Honda. But take a step back and just look at the interior. You will appreciate the lack of gimmicks in it, and it's rudimentary and purposeful. Whatever is given in the car works, and it works properly.
You also get Skoda's brand new Android infotainment system, which is basically an Android tablet stuck onto your car. You can basically do anything that your smartphone does on this tablet, which means you can go online, watch YouTube, surf the net, and also do your normal infotainment things like listen to the radio and so much more.
Apart from that, it gets a host of features, and these are the type of features which you will use in your day-to-day life. So it gets cruise control, it gets adaptive and automatic headlamps, it gets an auto-dimming rear view mirror, it gets a HD rear view camera with dynamic lines, and also it gets rain sensing wipers. And these are the type of features which you will use in your day-to-day life, which makes them super important. Rear seat comfort hasn't changed over the years. That's because if it ain't broke, why fix it? That's the type of mentality Skoda and VW have gone through. And I mean, they're completely right. This is more than ample space for any sort of human being. I have good knee room, I have good headroom, and you get a little bit of creature comforts as well. You get automatic power windows everywhere, and also you get a small cup holder and a 12-volt socket over here.
The Hyundai Verna's ventilated seats might be a really good creature comfort, but why do you need those if your climate control is working perfectly fine and getting the cabin cool very, very quickly? The Honda City's brand new digital instrument cluster might be an awesome gimmick and make the car feel really futuristic and expensive. But why do you need that if your analog setup is looking great and you also have a small digital cluster in between which gives you almost the same amount of information like the Honda City's? And come on, Honda really giving a G-force meter in a Honda City? What about the gearbox? So it's a 6-speed torque converter, and I'm going to be honest, if you're coming from a DSG car, this is going to feel a little bit slow for those people. But if you're coming from a different gearbox in general, like if you're coming from a Hyundai AMT, or if you're coming from a different torque converter gearbox from a different brand, this gearbox has to be one of the best torque converters in the business currently. Paired with the gearbox is, of course, the very familiar nowadays 1 liter TSI engine, and yeah, it is a really powerful engine. A few things which I don't like necessarily about the 1 liter TSI, first of all, is the sound. The 4-cylinder 1.2 TSI found in the older gen models sounds way better than this new 1 liter TSI.
Second thing is the engine refinement. Since 4 cylinders have an even number of cylinders, the firing of the pistons are evened out, thus making them smoother. Whereas in a 3-cylinder engine, there are odd numbers of cylinders, thus making them a little bit on the rougher side. But Skoda have done a great job in refining this engine, and as far as 3 cylinders go, this 1 liter TSI is very smooth.
The Rapid has always been a really comfortable and really reliable way of getting affordable luxury, at least in terms of feel. And this new 6-speed torque converter gives you those feels just like the previous DSG did. It shifts very seamlessly. You don't have any weird sort of clunking noises like an AMT. And yeah, in general, the driving experience is pretty similar to the older one. The suspension has also been incrementally improved. It's much more softer, it gets rid of the bumps in the road much better, and it's in general a much more comfortable car compared to the older PS4 versions.
The Rapid is an awesome little car, and over the years they've tweaked it in such a way that it's evolving into something which is a complete package. And in terms of reliability, practicality, and if you want an automatic gearbox, the Rapid is a really good option. And compared to its German counterpart and other counterparts from other brands, this is a really good deal because it's a lakh or two cheaper than its automatic counterparts from other rivals. So if you're looking for an automatic sedan which is not sub 4 meters and is a proper German sedan, the Rapid is the way to go.
A big thank you to Garve Skoda for letting us drive their Rapid 1-liter TSI automatic. They're an awesome new dealership based out of Pimpleghorov, and they have multiple dealerships scattered across the city. Out of the many VRS 245s allocated for Pune, Garve Skoda is getting a lot of them. So if you're interested in buying a Skoda vehicle, please do check out Garve Skoda.
Thank you so much for watching this video. A big thank you to Garve Skoda for helping us out in getting the new BS6 Automatic Rapid. Do check them out. Their links will be in the description. Subscribe to our channel. Let us know what you think about the Rapid, and we'll see you next time.